ground? Do you think Donald Trump can make up enough ground at that debate to make a difference in these battleground states?
No, I mean, it won't make the, I don't think it'll have the slightest bit of impact on the battleground states. I think, you know, the only way that Trump wins is if it's very organic and his believers, his cult comes out in force and comes out in far greater numbers than anybody expected. Mm-hmm. Because it won't happen because of his ground game that's non-existent. It won't happen because of any organization that's non-existent. It's going to have to be very organic and unexpected for him to win. Otherwise, he's got no chance.
What do you think about the whole strategy of, you know, bringing up Bill Clinton and his dalliances? And do you think that's going to be a part of this debate as well, especially considering now, again, that tape is the tape was out there for the last debate, but there are these women coming forward now. Do you think that's going to be part of his strategy?
What, for Donald to bring up some of Bill Clinton's former?
Yes, sir.
I don't think he'll bring them back. I think he kind of played that card and wasted it and used it. But obviously, it's going to be an issue. And, you know, the real question is, will any other new names or new victims pop up for tomorrow night?
Yeah. Do you know him, right?
Yes.
Do you?
We're not best friends, but yeah, we're more than acquaintances, I would say.
Have you ever heard of anything like these women coming forward or him being untoward?
Yes.
Or you have?
Yes, and I know one. And it just didn't happen recently. My friend reminded me, and it was from 2000. And she, you know, I don't expect her to come forward. I wouldn't recommend she come forward. I know somebody else from 2 years ago that won't come forward. So, you know, it's not anything that caught me by surprise.
So, again, this is you saying this is not CNN's reporting, but tell us what you can since you know him. What can you tell us?
I mean, that's what I can tell you. I can tell you, I mean, my friend that was dating this one woman, you know, just, you know, reminded me the story they told me right after it happened and put it all down in details. And obviously, I remembered it. And then I had another person who contacted me after the race started and told me a story. But I don't want to just go in since it's all second and third hand, other than to say that it's absolutely factually true. So I don't have any doubt that what we're hearing is true.
You're a very wealthy man. And I'm not sure if you saw the interview with Anderson and Melania Trump last night, but she said, you know, basically saying women throw themselves at him in front of her just because of money. You're a billionaire as well. Do you see any of this as, or maybe all of it as being political?
Yeah. I mean, look, it's all
are motivated by
right?
money.
Yeah. I mean, look, the word gold digger is there for a reason, right? And that's gender neutral. I've seen wealthy women who have been attracted, who had men attracted to them. So, but who knows, right? I'd like to think that they were attracted to me, but who knows? And so, yeah, I really couldn't speak to that.
Yeah. So let's get back now to the debate. Do you think that, because I think what the common wisdom is that she's running out the clock. And her supporters would like her to be a little bit more aggressive at the debate, maybe even more aggressive than last time. Do you think she should play it safe, or do you think she should take him on?
No, she definitely should play it safe. Look, you it's smart to get